I can bet that nobody has taught you in the way I am going to. So put your glasses on and watch this video completely. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. I get a lot of DMs, a lot of comments that their concealer always creases. And a couple of times when I took classes, I know the mistakes people do in the way they set their concealer. That's the reason, you know, their concealer actually creases. So I know the mistakes people make. So I thought, why not make a video about it? Because concealer creasing is a real problem. So I'm here to help you guys. Now, I might be putting myself at risk, like not really at risk, but in a position that I'm wrong. But I did a little research before doing this video. I did watch like so many videos to see actually if people spoke about, you know, the correct way of setting your concealer so that it doesn't crease. So that if there are so many videos like that, then there's no point of me making it. But when I watched all those videos, like literally nobody explains it properly. I mean, everybody gives a gist of what I am going to say, but people don't point out the mistakes you can do while you know setting your concealer. Because when you know the mistakes, is actually you'll know what is right and what is wrong. So yeah, I'm going to zoom you guys in properly. You're going to see where the concealer creases, how I'm going to set it. And if you like the video, then make sure you share and like and comment. I always forget to say this. I'm actually supposed to say it in the starting, because in the ending I think nobody watches this. So but yeah, let's get into the video. So I just have my foundation on because there's nothing related to foundation in this video. So in my previous video, basically I just popped the video here. I did go in with a little more concealer, like I just got carried away while talking to the camera. I did add a lot. So I just thought I'll show you how I actually use the amount of concealer I use as well. And that's like the ideal amount to use. This is like kind of the right way to do it, and that's what works for me as well. So first what I do is I go with a concealer which matches at least close to my skin tone. So I'm going with the LA Girl Medium Beige concealer. So I'm just going to concentrate it on the inner corner, right near this place where that, because that's where the under eye bags are, and right here. Same thing on the other side. If you need more, you can add later, but for starters, go with less. Now I'm just taking a damp sponge, Plumco sponge. So I slowly start blending it out. Now concentrate the product right where you placed it first, and then you can blend the rest of the concealer out. So I'm just taking the sponge and I'm concentrating and dabbing the product in that place for almost 2 to 3 seconds. I concentrate and dab it right there. I don't want to lose the coverage. You can see. So dabbing it right there. And that's it. It keeps blending on its own. You don't have to like drag the product around so much. So same goes for the other part. This video is not for how hairy Akanksha is, because I do have a lot of facial hair. So ignore that hair. So we do have a very nice thin layer of product, which looks really beautiful. Now you can completely stop at this, but I do like to brighten my under eyes a lot more. So I'm going to take this Maybelline Instant Age Rewind in the shade medium. So I'm just going to pop it right here and here. Last time I did apply a lot of product. Tiny dot in the middle too. Why not? So I'm just taking the same sponge and I'm dabbing it again on the area where I need that coverage and that brightening effect. And then I'm going to move along. So now the concealer is completely blended, but before starting like, you know, the process of how to set in and everything, first I think, let me just zoom you out 1 minute. So first, before going into creasing and how to set it, I think a lot of people don't understand creasing. They just do see fine lines and they think that it is actually like creasing. So I just pop on a picture right here. Like I did a makeup on this girl, Kriti. She's like really beautiful. I did this makeup. She did have a little, you know, intense dark circles. I did add a lot of concealer and I did didn't edit this picture at all, just added, like, removed little bumps here and there, but then the skin is untouched, no filter whatsoever. So this is her skin, and you can see that under her eyes there are a lot of fine lines. So there is no problem in having fine lines. Everybody have fine lines, and when you add makeup and you set it, the fine lines are enhanced a little more. So this is not creasing, you guys. And I did get comments under the picture as well that, you know, why does she have so many fine lines? I mean, guys, we are all humans, all of us have fine lines, there's nothing wrong in it. And but that is not called creasing. Those are just your fine lines which you have under the eyes, irrespective of you have makeup or not. But when you do wear makeup, they you know, do get enhanced a little more. But what creasing actually is, so you can see that, you know, concealer is gathering around these lines because I do have very fine lines there. And you can see in between that lines, let me zoom you more. Now in between those lines, you can see that there's some concealer which has collected, and this doesn't look appealing. You can see there's little collection here, little collection here, little here, because those are all fine lines that the concealer did go inside and settle there, because we, you know, didn't do anything to kind of set it. So that, you know, what you actually see is called creasing, and that is what you want to avoid in your makeup. The way you avoid creasing is using a powder, but creasing, like, you know, depends a lot on your skin type as well. Skin type as in, like, the age of your skin. Now, I'm 23, so I don't have, like, extreme bad lines. Like, I do have two lines here and there, but if you're more mature, like if you're 30 plus, 40 plus, it depends on your age, so you'll have more and more fine lines. So the more and more wrinkles or fine lines you have, the lesser product is better. But I'm going to show you how you can set it, even if you have that, you know, for how much ever lines you have. So ideally what happens is, now I am just going to blend this out. So I'm just making sure there are no creases before setting in with the powder, because this doesn't make any sense to set it with the creases. So on the left side, I'm going to show you how traditionally people show you to set your concealer. So they're just going to take a loose powder, and the concealer is there. So they're going to go in with the sponge, and ideally they're just going to, you know, set the concealer this way. And that's how they tell the creasing is going to stop. Now I'm going to leave it there, but I'm going to show you how ideally you're supposed to do it on the right side. So now, like you saw, that there is creasing inside the lines, you guys. So the main motto is to get that powder inside the line. So when you're going to set your concealer, when, like, you're just looking straight and you're setting your concealer, the lines are folded and the powder and the product inside the lines is not getting set whatsoever. So what you need to always make sure is that you go into the lines, and what you're supposed to do is you're supposed to stretch that complete skin out. So now my skin has fine lines, like right here. You can see that I have two prominent lines here. So this is where, like, the major or the majority of the creasing can happen for me. So if I open it here, like, so when I'm setting my concealer, my skin is supposed to be like this, because I need to get into that product. So what I do is I make a very weird face, like I stretch my face completely and I look up, so the entire, like, you know, part is completely stretched out and I don't have any fine lines there. After that, I take the powder, and once, like, you know, all that creasing is not there and the entire, you know, skin is stretched out, that's when I set with the powder. So you can see no creasing whatsoever, and push it inside. You're supposed to get into that line, like, make your skin as flat as you can and then get into that line and set it properly. Everybody usually makes this face. They do stretch their skin down, but nobody really explains why they do that. I mean, it comes very involuntarily when you are setting your you know, makeup or under eyes, but nobody explains it, nobody points it out, that that is because to make your skin lay down flat and then you set it and release it, that's when your concealer won't crease. So ideally nobody mentions that. I don't know, maybe it just slips out of the mind, but that is really, really important. You need to completely stretch your skin out before, you know, you go and set your concealer. That's it. Now when you stretch it, you cannot see the fine line or where the creasing is or anything of that sort. But let me show you this side. If I open up this side, you can see a little bit of creasing, and if you have a lot of lines, then you can see a lot of creasing. On this side, you can see that if I open it right here, So you can see that, you know, my concealer is creasing right here, a little on the edges right here as well. I did set this side also very properly, but I didn't stretch it out as much as this side. So you can see there is a little concealer creasing happening right here compared to this side. If I open this side, you can literally see nothing, like no creasing at all. Versus this side, there's a little bit of creasing. But if you do end up, you know, doing the left type of mistake sometimes, there's no issue. Just take a brush and now you, after, even after you said, you can still little get away with it because it's quite kind of little minor, it doesn't do so much. So open your eye and go with the brush and try to, you know, get what do you say, blend away that creasing with the powder. So this is just going to go into that line and set away that concealer, so there's no creasing again. You're just going to try get into that lines and blend it and make it creaseless. So I'm just setting everywhere else. Now smile lines is something I'd never experienced, so I really can't explain how to do it. And it's like, it is something which you cannot, like, you know, it's one concealer point which always tends to crease. A lot of people are tell to apply primer there and then do it. Now before going in with concealer and powder, I didn't show it to you in this video, but you can click in this video. I do, you know, prep my under eye area really well, so you can add a ton of moisturizer, a ton of eye cream, so that, you know, your eye area doesn't get dry and flaky while you have that makeup on, because you do add a concealer then a powder, which usually tends to make your, you know, skin a little dehydrated. So you need to really make sure your under eye is extremely hydrated before going in with makeup to avoid all that dryness or the flakiness which happens because of the concealer. So I'm just going to finish the rest of the makeup and I'll be right back. So I just wanted to show you guys one more thing which does help under eye creasing as well. So I did tell you guys that I do take a little bit of bronzer and I go under the lower lash line. So basically I go very close to the lower lash line, and that's where usually like really fine lines are. So it does help in creasing as well. So this is like a very tiny brush. I go around that area. So if you have extremely fine lines, what you can do is you can just avoid that area, right? Like just below the lash line, you can avoid, or maybe apply really less, and you can go in with the bronzer, some color shadow you want, and you can apply it so that you don't have like a lot of creasing. So before going in with this bronzer, I'll just show you this side compared to this side. Though I tried to fix this side is a little, you know, worse still than this side. You know, if I move close, you can see that there is a little bit of creasing going on right here, and there's a little creasing, like, you know, this, even after I tried to fix the situation, this is what is going on. So this side, and you can see on versus this side, this is quite neat, like nothing is like creasing a lot, everything is very properly set, there's nothing, you know, no issue happening on this side. And creasing is something which does differ in like a lot of people, you guys. So if people have under eye fillers, they don't have so many fine lines because the filler kind of fills off those lines and kind of makes it more flat, so they don't have so many lines. So a little powder, maybe like the way applied on this side, kind of can remove off the creasing easily. And sometimes people don't just have fine lines, a lot of people don't have fine lines or anything, so the concealer doesn't crease. But I do have fine lines and this is the way I do it. Now creasing on some people shows very prominently. Like for me, if I, like, you know, make any stretch on the face, something like that, that's when you can properly see creasing. But few people who have like that more rounded edge and the lines are like very visible, without them, you know, stretching their skin only, they can see. So just, you know, the best way you can set it is to get into the line, like make your skin a little flat and then properly get into that lines and set your face. So those are my few tips to stop your concealer from creasing. So I hope this video was useful. Comment below and tell me if anybody has taught you how to set the concealer the way I showed you. It's not like I'm boasting or anything. I know 10% of what makeup is, or maybe even 5, but I did watch videos and nobody has explained it like the way actually I'd set my concealer. So I just thought it would be helpful for people. That's the reason I did the video. And yeah, if you find it useful and if you like my video, then make sure you like, share and subscribe to my channel. It would mean the absolute world to me. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye. And yeah, my Instagram is Akanksha Khomireli. I always have it in the description and I always have it in the screen as well. I don't know why people are not finding it. But yeah, it is at Akanksha Khomireli. You can definitely follow me there. It's a fun time. And yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.